Hi everyone. So in this video, we'll see how we can use CabVision to create a custom built-in microwave cabinet similar to the one you see on the screen. So in order to build this cabinet, I will go back to my plan view and I will go in my object catalog and just use a custom base cabinet. And it doesn't matter what cabinet you use, just make sure it's a base cabinet. Drag and drop it on my wall. You might want to already change the size of your cabinet if you know it, but I will leave it to my default size, which is 30 by 24 inches. Next, you want to double click on the cabinet to go to the section editor. So the section editor is accessed by clicking on the section tab. And now we are in the section editor. The first thing you want to do is to delete all the parts you don't need. So in this case, to do that, you can click on the delete button on the toolbar. Make sure no object is selected. So if you select an object first, make sure you left click outside the window to unselect it, and now click on the delete button. We will say yes to erase all face and interior parts. So at this point, we just have the cabinet case open with no interior or exterior part, just the case. Next, I will go back to my section tab and I will start sectioning my cabinet. So what I will do, I'm right now using the section face of the cabinet and I will use the horizontal multi-split tool. Select it, click one time inside my cabinet, and I will divide my cabinet into three equal openings, and I will leave the opening type to the default drawer separator. Next, I will start working from the bottom. So I'll select my bottom drawer front and set the height to 12 inch. Once I press enter and change the height to 12 inch, I will also lock the height just in case I resize my cabinet. I want to make sure that the drawer at the bottom is always 20 inch high. Next thing, I will select my drawer front at the middle and I will change the type to a panel. So that will be kind of a little filler I put between the bottom drawer and the microwave. So I will not resize the part yet because I want to resize the microwave opening. So for the microwave opening, I will change the type to open and I'll set the height to 16 inches. And I will also lock the height as well. So by locking the height, if I make a change to my cabinet height, only the filler will be adjusted, but my drawer front will be locked to 12 inch and my microwave opening will be locked to 16 inch. So at this point, because we started with drawer front, so if we switch to the section interior, we'll find out that CabVision in my case already put a drawer stretcher. But if you don't, or if you don't have it, or if you want to modify it, let's delete it. And I will put instead a fixed shelf. So I'll click on horizontal split. And what you want to do is to click exactly on the line between the microwave opening and the filler. By doing so, CabVision will automatically place a fixed shelf object. So if I select the object, this is a fixed shelf between those two openings. And also, if you happen to resize the face of the cabinet, the microwave opening, the fixed shelf will automatically move as well. And we can test this by unlocking the microwave opening and making it, for example, 14 inches. And you see that the fixed shelf move accordingly. So I'll go back to 16 inches and lock it again. So if I check now my cabinet, so I have the drawer front at the bottom, the filler, and the opening for the microwave. And just to make it complete, we'll go back to the section editor. In the section interior, we will use the object tool. So we want to insert an object. So you have the microwave opening selected. You select the type object. And now you will have access to your catalog to insert any object inside this opening. And the object you will insert will automatically be resized to fit the opening you selected. So in my case, I'm in my appliance catalog. Microwave, and now select the microwave 3 and drag and drop it in my opening. And now, as you can see, you have your custom built-in microwave cabinet created. And if you want to save it in your catalog, you can go back to your plan view by pressing return, right-click on the object, and in the wheel, you select the option save as. And now you can set a name, custom microwave, change the icon, select microwave icon, and click OK. Now the object is saved in your catalog. See, if I go back to my catalog, I can find it under custom built-in microwave. So I can drag and drop it. And because we use the section editor, we can also resize it. So if I change the width to 24, the depth to 18, and double click to go in the cabinet editor, I can see that everything is resized properly.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a Cabinet Vision Power user.